Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Assalamualaikum. Welcome to the channel, beautiful people. I hope you guys are having yourself a wonderful day. In today's video, guys, we'll be reacting to a video of a lady fixing fractures. This video was suggested by Joel Clark. Terima kasih. Thank you very much. Shukran merci for your kind suggestion. The video is by Bang Joel69, and the link is in the description in case you guys wanted to check it out. So without further ado, guys, let's get started this video. Oh. I don't think fractures, I think it's dislocation. Oh, yeah, because fracture is when you actually break, put a little bit of like a cut, like a break to some extent, right? Like that's what they call a fracture in through the bone. That the only way you can heal that is through time. But this location where a joint pops out and stuff, I think this is what she's doing. And we have something similar in Afghanistan as well, where people just basically work on helping people relocate their joints. And I think the lady here is doing that same thing. Some places, you know, like for example third world countries, you know, like I said, even Afghanistan, where there's not a lot of medical places that you can go, like doctors and specialists, right? So there are people that basically specialize in this, and through experience and years of working on the joints, they just kind of learn how to basically push the joints back into the position. And sometimes with kids or even adults, you fall or you move and, you know, you dislocate your joint, then you basically go to them and they kind of just pop it back in. There you go. Back in place. We saw that just earlier, but they brought back a clip that they're gonna try to put this. Even also fingers, I think, just kind of that's just me, she can move on. There we go, she popped it back in. Oh, Cinda, there you go. Back in. Just so you know, people that are watching, for example, this is not black magic, this is not shirk, it's nothing like that. It's just understanding human body, for example, right? Like understanding when you dislocate, how you should try to rotate which part of the body, the limb, to be able to put it back into this the position. I've you know, one time I dislocated my shoulder, I was pushing a fridge, but alhamdulillah, it didn't really go too out, and it came back in. But there's some people that stays out, then the only way is you have to go to a doctor, and they basically kind of push it back in, and, you know, this lady, the sister, seems to have the experience to push those dislocated joints back into place. That's about it. And people go to her basically because, you know, she has the experience from the over the years, because you can see she's pretty old, right? Like she's age old. That's probably experience of over the years. I think his left hand too, just like that sister earlier. Oh.
Umpama kalau tidak sembuh, kalau tidak bisa, jangan marah ya. Namanya saya manusia biasa. Mudah-mudahan namanya berusaha ya. manusia hanya berusaha dan berdoa. Yang menyembuhkan Bapak.
Because it's so painful, subhanallah, I kind of feel tense just watching it.
Jadi mintanya itu tidak boleh minta sama manusia, tidak boleh. Mintanya sama Gusti Allah ya. Doanya seperti ini. Kalau memang enggak sembuh, kalau enggak bisa sembuh jangan marah ya. Nih, kita cek. Bacaannya cukup doanya dengan agama saya Islam Muslim. Bacaannya cukup Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
She's Muslim, so just need Bismillahirrahmanirrahim to get started.
Ya Allah, sembuhkanlah mertua saya. Siapa tahu ada bapak punya keluarga di rumah tetangga atau punya mertua sakit sudah setahun.
And my daughter, when she was young, about 2 years old, we were just holding her hand and she dislocated her hand and she, you know, couldn't move it. So when we went to the hospital, the nurse just basically popped it and just went back into place, and she started stopped crying like nothing had ever happened. So similarly here too, sometimes you're pulling something or maybe you fall, something happens and you just dislocate that joint, and after that you can't move it because it's so painful since it's not sitting in the right place. And like I said, the sister has the experience where, you know, just pushes it back into place. No black magic, no you know, sorcery, nothing like that. Just like I said, the autonomy of the human body, understanding where how the joints sit and the muscles and how to push it to put it back into place. That's about it. In med school, they teach the nurses and the doctors these tests, so, you know, when you go to a hospital, they do the same thing. She's using that liquid, but you don't need to use that, I don't think so.
Pengobatan gratis dimulai. Tidak boleh ngasih duit, tidak boleh bayar. Biarpun tidak beli.
Eh, kita mana pinggang lah.
Saya tes barangnya ya. Mari sini, tolong tes. Tolong dijajakan. Satu. Dua. Satu. Kalau tidak bisa sembuh, kalau tidak bisa lurus, jangan marah kalau tidak bisa lurus ya. Tulangnya sudah sembuh. Ya, satu. Ibu.
Terima kasih, Jun.
Sudah baca bismillah ya? Tolong dipegang. Sudah 2 tahun ya. Sudah berapa tahun, Mak?
2 tahun.
Enggak bisa gendong istri, enggak bisa megang susu ya. Arugi. Gendong istri tidak bisa, jatuh. Satu.
Atau
sayang barangnya terbatas lah ya.
Maaf barangnya.
You see, look how tense his hand was, or his elbow, and then as soon as she pushed it back, it just sat in place, and you know you're able to, alhamdulillah, move it easily around. You can see how she pops it into place. There you go. That's it. That's about it. That's a hospital.
Jangan gosok dalam celana. Tulang yang keluar, tulang metu masuk. Tulang yang patah jatuh tibo. 2 tahun tibo ya. Tibo di jalan. Kaperakan itu bapak punya motor, hati-hati. Kalau punya Honda jangan ngebut. Kencang punya motor. Kencang ngebut. Jatuh ke jurang. Belokan kaperakan itu jatuh tibo di motor. Lurus ya. Yakin bapak gosok di mana sakit? 1 tahun, 5 tahun sakit tak bisa tekuk. Mau dilipat sakit tak bisa ditekuk. Mau berdiri sakit sakit. Tinggal gosok oles di mana sakit sembuh. Minum penyakit paru-paru, sesak, jantung, ginjal, meripat, kabut.
And I think they're selling something too, because the brother that's sitting there with a hat, some people are coming and giving them stuff, maybe that oil. But like I said, that oil is not necessary. As long as you have the knowledge of just how to push the joints back into place, that's about it.
Yang diminum yang banyak. Tolong sapu tangan. Cuman barangnya enggak banyak ya. Pusakanya kecil tapi satu kali gosok, satu kali minum. Ya, lumpuh 5 tahun. Bawa sini yang lumpuh. Berapa satu botol? Ya, cuman ini 5 aja ya, 5 ya. Nggak boleh banyak. Karena barangnya mau dibawa ke sana nanti di pasar besok. Itu 100, nggak boleh 50. Lihat. Kalau uang 50 beli rokok 2 bungkus, anggap beli rokok 2 bungkus ya. Saya enggak ya rugi saya jual 50, 100 besok di pasar sana. Nah, oh, orang Jawa enggak takut mahal, yang penting biar mahal jangankan 100.000, 300, 300, 200 dibeli, asal sembuh, asal mari. Hati-hati kalau ngapusi, itu aja. Kalau enggak sembuh orang Jawa enggak mau beli. Nah, kalau sembuh biar mahal, orang Jawa enggak takut mahal. Biar 200, 300. 1, 2, 3, kasih lurus ya. Berapa biji? 50.000 saja ya, kasih ya pusaka. Pusaka.
Before the brother was holding his arm like that, then now you can see
pusaka ini ada, hanya ada di Pulau Kalimantan. Tapi kalau ke sana, ongkos tiket pesawatnya 4 juta bolak-balik kalau mau beli ke sana. Di Jawa tidak ada, seluruh Jawa keliling. Keliling cari, kalau ada di Jawa bawa sini. Bawa sini tes tangan bengkong-bengkong. Ya, tes dulu tangan bengkong-bengkong kalau ada di Jawa. Tes dulu asli enggak minyaknya. Kalau barang asli tes tangan bengkong-bengkong yang
interesting guys, very very interesting. Like I said, in Afghanistan we have something similar where people that dislocate their arms, their legs, shoulder or anything like that, they go to this person and they basically do same thing. They use like Vaseline or something just to soften, I guess, or make the skin a little bit slippery or so, and then they just pull it or push it and then the joint basically goes back into a place. And this is not like I said, sorcery or magic. It's just understanding the human body and how to, for example, push, how to hold the hands, right? Like maybe you don't want to do it like this, you have to hold it like that and pull it, right? Just having a little bit of knowledge of that, it helps. But you don't need to buy those oils or anything like that. And I wasn't understanding what the sister was saying, so in no way do I endorse for example, or reject what she's saying, because I didn't understand it, but I'm just going based on the visuals or what I'm watching, and this is more for education as well as criticism. So like I said, I agree with what she's doing, the physical part of it, because I've seen it, and I know people that do it in Afghanistan, but if she's selling that oil is not, doesn't have any importance to it, because like I said, it's just understanding it, like physiotherapist, how you go, and then they help you with certain exercises because they have studied it. They know, for example, what you can do to help with your muscle pain and whatnot. So this was really, really interesting. I didn't know, for example, that this would be in Indonesia. Like I said, we have it also in Afghanistan. So thank you very much. I learned something new today, and I hope you guys did too. If you did, then please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, thank you, thank you, thank you very much for all your love and support. I hope you guys have yourself a wonderful day. Take care of yourself and your family, inshallah. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care and wassalam.